My dear students, I am sure you all are safe and healthy at home. I am Nazia Siddiqui, your bio teacher. So today, I am connecting you all with my online classes. I hope you all will enjoy this class. Believe me, it's a very easy and interesting chapter. So let's start this chapter. But before starting this chapter, let's understand the meaning of food resources. Food resources that are used as food or provide food for organism are called food resources. We know that majority of people obtain food from cultivated plants and domesticated animals. Now, the name of the chapter is Important Improvement in Food Resources. So, the first question that comes in our mind is that why there is need to do improvement in food resources. As you know that our country is second in population in the world with approximately 125 crores. For such a huge population, we will require 241 million tons of grain production per annum to feed our people. Therefore, it is necessary to increase the production of plants and animals. This resulted in a variety of revolutions which made India self-reliant. These revolutions include Green Revolution. So, what is Green Revolution? It is a program introduced in many countries to increase food production by use of modern technology, proper irrigation, improved seed, etc. Means, it is a program by which we can maximize the production of crops. Now, let's talk about White Revolution. It is another program by which we can increase the milk production. This program made India sufficient in production of milk. Now, the next is Blue Revolution. Here, blue denotes water. Now, what is the basic food that we get from water? We get fishes from water. So, in this program, various methods have been taken to increase the production of fishes. Now, it's Yellow Revolution. In this program, we have taken several steps to improve production of oil. Now, we will see what is sustainable agriculture. Sustainable agriculture is a type of agriculture that focuses on producing long-term crops and livestock while having minimal effects on the environment. Sustainable agriculture also focuses on maintaining economic stability of farms and helping farmers improve their techniques and quality of life. With increased human population of our country, the natural resources such as land, soil, water, etc. are being overexploited for food, shelter and urbanization. All these human activities have degraded our environment and have caused many problems such as floods, drought, ozone depletion, etc. Thus, it has become far important that we should increase food production without degrading and disturbing our environment. So, dear students, in recent year, a concept of sustainable agriculture is developed. It is sustainable agriculture which ensures pollution-free food production and continuation of agriculture with least damage to ecosystem. Sustainable agriculture includes organic farming, biological and natural control of pests, emphasis on watershed approach to conserve the soil and water. Now, about organic farming. We know that continuous use of fertilizers and pesticides in crop fields is harmful not only for us but also for the environment. These chemical fertilizers that we are using in our field get mixed with water and they also cause water pollution. So, to minimize the use of these fertilizers and chemicals in our crop field, we have started a new method of farming that is called organic farming. It is the practice of raising crops in which there is no use of chemical fertilizers, pesticides and herbicides. Therefore, there is no toxicity due to pollution of crop plants, soil, water or air. So organic farming is basically a technique which involves cultivation of plants and rearing of animals in natural ways. This process involves the use of biological materials, avoiding synthetic substances to maintain soil fertility and ecological balance, thereby minimizing pollution and wastage. So obviously organic farming is helping us to save our environment, as well as it is also helping us in enhancing the agricultural products. Now, organic farming has some advantages. Just two. So, what are the advantages of organic farming? The advantages of organic farming are lower input costs, improved soil structure, premium price, it adds value, it is environment friendly. Now, what are the disadvantages of organic farming? The disadvantages of organic farming are lower productivity, it is very time consuming, it requires a lot of skills, it has production, its production cost is very high. Now, we know that different crops require different climatic conditions, temperature for their growth and maturity. As you have already studied in class 8, that in India there are two main seasons of crop growth, Kharif and Rabi. Now let's talk about Rabi and Kharif crops. You already know that Rabi crops, they are generally planted in November and they are harvested in April. Some examples of Rabi crops are wheat, barley, pea and gram. They are generally planted in June and they are harvested in October. Rice, maize, cotton and groundnuts are some example of kharif. Now what is the basic difference between kharif and rabi crops? First, kharif crops, they are monsoon or rainy season crops. Means we sow these crops during the monsoon or rainy season. Rabi, on the other hand, the Rabi crops, they are non-monsoon season crops. Second difference is that. Now we will study that what are the differences between Kharif and Rabi crops. Kharif crops and Rabi crops. Kharif crops, they are monsoon or rainy season crops. On the other hand, Rabi crops, they are non-monsoon season crops. Second difference is that Kharif crops, we can grow in hot and wet conditions. But Rabi crops, they need dry conditions to grow. Kharif and Rabi crops. Now we have to study that what are the scientific approaches that we are adopted in India to obtain high yields from our agriculture farm. We know that we all have understood that why there is need to do improvement in crop production. In India, we are applying various methods to increase crop production. Now following, three scientific approaches are adopted in India to obtain high yields from agriculture farms. First is improvement in crop variety. Second is management of crop production. Third is management of crop protection. Now, what are the objectives of crop variety improvement? Now first, what is the need or why it is essential to increase the productivity of crops on the limited land area available for cultivation, or to provide food and fodder for continuously increasing human population and its livestock. Now we will see what are the objectives of crop variety improvement. So the common objectives of crop variety improvement are, first, we will get high yielding variety of crop. We will improve the quality of crops. We will see some variety which are resistant to biotic and abiotic factors. We will be able to develop desirable agronomic traits that we require. Next, wider adaptability, so that our crops will be adapted to various atmospheric conditions, easy to acclimatize. So these are the objectives of crop variety improvement that we need to